something like El Chavo. In the vecindario, it was hard, we had a struggle. Now we getting paper, en el otro lado. Came across the border, so they call me El Mojado.
My real legal name is Billy Rosales, middle initial V, which is for Vladimir. I go by the name of Billy the Kid, that's my rap name. If you guys know the story of Billy the Kid from back in the day, especially if you guys have watched the movie Young Guns, which is all about his life. Basically, Billy the Kid used to like killing, shooting. How I got the name from that is because I like to kill beats. So that's how Billy the Kid came about. Originally, I'm from El Salvador, which is the smallest country in Central America. So I'm Latino to the bone, repping for all my people. So if you haven't tried pupusas, make sure you guys go and cop some, man. There's pupusas are the shit. Chingo Bling, one of the skits, he started calling me the pupusa prince, so.
They call me three-time wetback cause I went through tres fronteras. I gotta give my hustle on el tiempo no espera.
After coming from El Salvador, stayed for a few weeks in Texas, but all my family is out there in California. I was out there for a few years in California, Orange County, Santa Ana, but now I'm out here in Nebraska, and I've been here for over a decade now. Pretty much grew up out here in the Midwest. I think back in Cali, how our own people beef with each other. Some Dorians were like Mexicans, etc. Even in the East Coast, the same thing. Puerto Ricans don't like Mexicans or, you know, Cubans, vice versa. At the end of the day, to me, I'm all about Latino. I really don't play all that. To me, if you're brown, we all got the same goals in life. I guarantee you that you grew up eating beans, you know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, that's really how I look at things. I don't care your nationality, where you're from, the color of your skin, etc. I grew up with nothing but Mexicans out here in the Midwest. Growing up, one of my best friends was black too. I grew up with different cultures. I had some homies that were white, Middle Eastern, Asian. So I mean, I grew up with a little bit of everything. So again, at the end of the day, to me, it's all about getting that green, you know what I'm saying? I don't do no other color but green, baby. Growing up, I used to listen to everything. The thing is, being Latino, mom always had some Spanish music playing. She used to listen to Los Temerarios, Los Bukis, obviously with Los Bukis, Marc Antonio Solís, Cumbias, Maná. I grew up listening to that. I used to like that music as well from my mom listening to it. First hip-hop song that I ever heard, or not song but album, was actually Eminem, the Marshall Mathers album. Ever since then, I fell in love with hip-hop. I grew up listening to everything from New York with Jay-Z all the way to Cali with Snoop Dogg, Dr. Dre, all that West Coast shit, also Latin rap, Spanish rap, Dirty South shit, Tupac, Biggie, just all that old school shit, real live music, but I would be at parties, you know what I'm saying? I used to like that party shit too, to get you in the vibe, you know what I'm saying? Get turned up. My opinion on today's rap, honestly, I don't really listen to what's out now. I get kids that listen to my music, you know, and they'll ask me like, oh, did you hear so-and-so's new mixtape? I do keep my ears on the streets, you know what I'm saying, as far as what's out right now, but I don't go out of my way to go listen to it just because I'm focused on me and my music, you know what I'm saying? No disrespect, I just stick to what I grew up listening to. You know, if you go to my Pandora, that's really what you're gonna find is, you know, anywhere from a cumbia station, corrido station, you know, to some Ludacris or 50 Cent, you know what I'm saying? And just whatever I grew up listening to is what I put, you know, what I listen to. Otherwise, again, I'm just focused on my career and, you know, my music. To make music, just life in general is what inspires me. All the struggles that I've gone through, everything that I've seen in life, you know, growing up without a father as a kid, all the trouble that I went through as a teen or now as an adult. I did everything from fast food to working at a hotel when I was just a teen. I've always liked working. I worked at Burger King, I worked at Taco Bell. I did my little side hustle as well, however I could do it to make money, because again, I'm coming from a single parent home where my mom, all she was worried about was paying the bills. We were under the welfare, food stamps and all that. I had to do whatever I had to do so I can go buy me some clothes. Basically just take care of my own self is basically what I was trying to do at that time. Doing that was me helping my mom not worry about me And obviously I would also help her out with whatever I would be able to. When you're a teen, there's only so much money that you're able to make legally.
I started doing my
side thing, you know, as well. And just basically a troubled teen, not worried about anything. My mind was just blank, smoking, drinking, partying every weekend. There were times where I would just skip school for a whole week just to party. So that was just my mentality at that age, you know, when I was a teen. And I just thank God for making me who I am today and putting me where I'm at now, where now I think clearly, I'm more educated, I'm more responsible. Now I'm able to further and take this music career more serious, so that way I can get it to the next level. You know, I just put whatever I see in life and I put my perspective on that, put it on music.
Especially having depression problems lately. You know, that's how I release, that's my therapy, is going to the studio, spitting. You know what I'm saying? That's really how I release what I have inside, all the anger and all that. You know, I just put it on my music. And that's how I release it. That's my therapy. That's how I get it out.
To feel better.
No matter what the subject is or what kind of song I'm doing, you're always gonna hear my point of view in that subject. Instead of me going back trying to shoot somebody, I would go back and just make a song out of it. That's how I used to release it. Especially now that I'm older, that's how I release all my thoughts and anger and everything that I got inside of me. If it has kept me from trouble, you know what I'm saying? Just releasing it through beats.
In this cold world, bitch, I gotta hide my heat. At school, I fell asleep. All I know is from the street. Now I'm on a beat. Music got me on my feet. Fans got me on repeat. Pussies mad, they can't compete.
Mixtapes or albums, you can hear a little bit of everything on them. You could go from a real life type of track where I'm talking about just real life shit, you know, and then you could go to another track where it's all party and for you to get turned up. I got some shit for the hustlers, like my players, just a little bit of everything, you know what I'm saying? I keep it open when it comes to being an artist. I like to make music for everybody. My point of view, you know, how I view that type of scenario, whether it's at a party, club, or real life shit, get money shit, etc. Just how I view it. I started doing music professionally back in early 2005. I had a radio interview. During that radio interview out here locally, I hooked up with some people, got some contacts in order for me to get in the studio professionally, and then that's when I started investing in my career and, you know, getting studio time. Before I actually hit the studio, Walmart, I had a karaoke machine. That's how I used to record. My first recordings was through a karaoke machine on a tape. Way before that, I always had the thought of doing something, music or TV. I always liked just entertainment overall. Everybody used to hit me up to get what's new, especially back then when you used to be able to download music on the internet. People would hit me up like, hey, let me get the new mix, you know what I'm saying? And you know, I would burn them the top 15 tracks that everybody's bumping. So that's really how I used to always love music. I wrote my first song when I was like 9 or something, 8 maybe. It was just a stupid song, you know what I'm saying? And now I look back, I laugh at it, but that's really when I first wrote my first song. It was just about female shaking their booty.
So, when I say billionaire, you say
you know, it's coming from my point of view, my personal experience. But again, I just let people choose it. I put out whatever I want to put out as far as music goes. It doesn't bother me what people will think about it or none of that. Beyond that, I don't really care what people think of my music or of me in any negative way. I just let people choose whatever music they like. My first album was all Spanish, and that's when I got signed Thump Records out there in Cali, Universal. And I don't want to get too detailed in that situation, but I had to get a lawyer to get me out of that deal. And they did the shit with that through Universal. That deal right there is really what
what made me smarter and a businessman about it, because the way that they were doing me at that time made me realize that if you don't have your feet on the ground and the knowledge that you need for this business, then you ain't going nowhere and you're gonna get screwed over. So after I signed with Thumb Records and Universal Distribution, I educated myself to learn about the music business, and that's how I started my own label, New Era Music. Total, right now I got 2 mixtapes, Live the Flyway, Stay Fresh, and The Good Life. My solo projects, I got New Era, I got American Dream, and Spanglish. I got a couple compilations out there, one I did with Zigzag from Emmy Writers called The Money. And then the recent one that I just dropped this year is with Lucky Luciano, Get Money, Grind Hard, or Starve. The 2 projects is me and that artist together throughout the whole album. And I guarantee you that you will find something that you can relate to in every single album or project that I have out there. So make sure you guys support and show your voice of love and go grab a copy. Right now I'm working on my solo project, Born Alone, Die Alone. And before that, I mean, I got so much music recorded. For sure we're gonna throw you guys something out there, you know, that way you guys could bump it before the album Born Alone, Die Alone comes out. So whatever doesn't make it in the album Born Alone, Die Alone, I'm gonna go ahead and put a mixtape together off of it. Make sure you guys follow me on Twitter and Instagram at Billy the Kid. Go like my music page, facebook.com/BillyTheKid. And also please subscribe on my channel on YouTube, youtube.com/BillyTheKid. That's where we're gonna be releasing all brand new music videos. We got a lot of stuff coming up, so make sure you guys keep following me. And as long as you guys keep supporting, I'm gonna keep doing my thing, baby. Billy the Kid, aka BDK, the Nino.
Traffic light colors like Bob Marley. Dress so flawless, you know I'm getting money. Red, yellow, green, looking so clean. Pockets with green and my brand new jeans.
Like Ray J, I have one wish. No more war, all I want is world peace. We all human, let's all unite. What am I saying? I'm just highlighting.